Hey there, Benjamin from Loves Data here. If you've recently configured a data stream in GA4, Google Analytics 4, or you've been in your Google Ads account, then you might have noticed the new Google tag. So what is the Google tag? When should you use it? And what are the benefits? Well, I'm going to answer these questions and more in this video. The Google tag, or gtag.js, lets you send data to Google Ads and Google Analytics. It's designed to streamline your implementation. For example, you can create a single Google tag and use it to send data to Google Analytics and Google Ads at the same time. There are also additional settings you can adjust without having to modify any code. Okay, let's jump in and cover some of the most important questions about the Google tag. First, what do I need to do if I've been using the global site tag? If you've previously installed the global site tag on your website, then you don't need to make any adjustments to your existing tag. Basically, the Google tag is the global site tag. Google has renamed the tag, so it's now called the Google tag, and they've also added additional features and functionality to the tag. These additional options can be configured in Google Analytics, Google Ads, and Google Tag Manager. And I'll talk more about these options later in this video. Next, how can I tell if I'm using the Google tag? Here we can see an example of a Google tag. We can see it references a JavaScript file, which is located at googletagmanager.com/gtag/. The fact that it includes gtag tells us that this is a Google tag. If you're looking at the code for your own website, then the two tag IDs contained in your tag will be different to the one in my example. And these IDs can be different depending on when your tag was created and if you created the tag in Google Ads or Google Analytics. For example, if your tag was created in a Google Analytics 4 property, then your ID will be a G- followed by a combination of numbers and letters. Your Google tag could also start with a GT- or AW-2. Now let's compare this to Google Tag Manager. Here we can see an example of a Google Tag Manager container. We can see the container code also includes the googletagmanager.com domain, but it is followed by /gtm.js. Since GTM stands for Google Tag Manager, we know this isn't the same as the Google tag we looked at previously. Also, the container ID is GTM-, so again we know this is for Google Tag Manager. Now you might be wondering, do I need to do anything if I'm already using Google Tag Manager? The answer to this question is simple. No, you don't need to do anything if you're currently using Google Tag Manager. The Google tag is designed for people who aren't using Google Tag Manager. So if you're already using Google Tag Manager to send data to Google Analytics, Google Ads, and other platforms, then you don't need to do anything. However, if you're just using Google Tag Manager to send data to Google Analytics, and you then decide to send data to Google Ads, then you have a choice. You can either connect your existing Google Analytics measurement ID to Google Ads, or you can add the Google Ads tag to your website using Google Tag Manager. And just to highlight, you don't need to do both. For example, you don't need to add both Google Tag Manager and the Google tag to your website. This isn't necessary. Now, you're probably wondering, who should use the Google tag? Overall, anybody who isn't using Google Tag Manager, and they haven't added additional third-party tags to their website, like the Facebook pixel or other tracking or marketing tags. And they don't expect to need additional tags or tracking in the short or medium term. If someone meets all three of these criteria, then using the Google tag could be a good option because it's quicker to get up and running compared to implementing Google Tag Manager. So the Google tag is really designed for anybody who only needs to send data to Google Analytics and Google Ads. However, this recommendation might change as Google adds more features to the Google tag. Next, where can I find the Google tag? Let's take a look at where we can find our Google tag in Google Analytics. First, we navigate to Admin. Then we select Data Streams. Choose our data stream, scroll to the bottom, and select View Tag Instructions. Now we can select the Install Manually tab, and we're given our Google tag for Google Analytics. Okay, now let's head to Google Ads to find our tag. Let's select Tools and Settings, and then we select Google Tag under Setup. Now we select Installation Instructions, and then Install Manually. We now have our Google tag for Google Ads. Okay, now let's head to Google Tag Manager. We select the Google Tag tab at the top, and we can see all of the Google tags we have access to. We can then select the tag we want, and again we can select Installation Instructions, then Install Manually, and we can get the Google tag code. So you can find your Google tags in Google Analytics, Google Ads, and Google Tag Manager. And what features can I configure for the Google tag? Let's head back to Google Analytics to take a look. We're back at the admin area for Google Analytics, so let's select Data Streams. And let's open the data stream. Now let's select Configure Tag Settings under Google Tag. We can see a few configuration options here, but let's click Show All on the right. We can see a number of configuration options for our Google tag. There are options to manage events that the tag automatically collects. We can configure cross-domain tracking if we expect users to travel between multiple domains we manage for our business, along with additional configuration options. Now let's select the Admin tab at the top. This gives us additional options for the Google tag. Let's select Manage Google Tag. We can now see there is an option to combine this tag with another tag. This lets you join tags together so that they send data to the destinations that have been configured for the tags. For example, if you have two tags installed on different pages on your website, then combining them will mean that data from both tags is sent to the destinations you specify in the tag configuration. Or if you want to install multiple tags on your website, you can combine them and just install one. Then, even though you've only added one tag to your website, it will act as if you've installed both tags. Below this, we can see there is an option to add destinations to our Google tag. This option lets you control where data is sent from your tag. For example, you could use a single Google tag to send data to Google Analytics and Google Ads without needing to modify the tag. Finally, what if I modified the global site tag? Before I answer this question, let's look at an example of a modified global site tag. Here we can see a modified tag that will send data to Google Analytics and Google Ads. As we've just covered, we can now achieve this in the interface without having to modify the actual tag. So if you've modified the global site tag to send data to multiple destinations, then you can leave the tag as it is, or you can use the option to combine the tags in the interface. If you decide to combine the tags in the interface, then make sure you select the option to ignore duplicate instances of on-page configuration. Otherwise, you might be sending duplicate information to Google. And if you combine the tags in the interface, then you can also switch to the default Google tag, since you've already adjusted the configuration for the tag. Remember, if you're already using Google Tag Manager, then you don't need to change your tags. And if you've been using the global site tag, gtag.js, then you're already using the Google tag. You can adjust the configuration options for the Google tag in Google Ads, Google Analytics, and Google Tag Manager. Are you using the Google tag or Google Tag Manager? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.